Hi everyone, welcome to Wits Connect. Today we are going to discuss the topic about block diagram of operational amplifier, or simply op amp. We can say it as op amp. Okay, na? Op amp is nothing but operational amplifier, and the IC number it is IC741. What is IC? IC is nothing but integrated circuit. What is IC? IC is nothing but in IC, the number of active and passive components are fabricated in a single chip. That is the definition of integrated circuit or IC. Okay, na? Here for an op amp, the IC number is going to be, it is 741. Okay, so coming to the block diagram of operational amplifier. So it consists of mainly four blocks. Those are nothing but input stage, intermediate stage, level shifting stage, output stage. Coming to the first one, input stage. So here the input stage is having two inputs. Those are nothing but inverting input and non-inverting input. Here input stage is nothing but it acts as a differential amplifier. Input stage is nothing but it is a differential amplifier. What is differential amplifier? Differential amplifier is a circuit. It accepts two inputs or two input signals and amplifies the difference between these two input signals. That is the definition of differential amplifier. Here the input stage is nothing but differential amplifier. Okay, na? So this input stage provides maximum voltage gain. This input stage provides maximum voltage gain, and so in this stage differential amplifier with a constant current source. In this stage the differential amplifier with a constant current source will provides high amount of common mode rejection ratio. Okay, na? So coming to the second stage, intermediate stage. This is also another differential amplifier. It is going to improve the gain once again. Improve the amplifier gain once again. So it is nothing but again, it is a differential amplifier. Here the output of the input stage is given to the intermediate stage. It is nothing but another, again it is differential amplifier. Okay, na? It provides high amount of voltage gain. Okay, na? So coming to the next stage, level shifting stage. So this level shifting stage is nothing but emitter follower stage or buffer stage. Okay, na? So this level shifting stage provides unity gain. It provides unity gain. The level shifting stage produces gain. That is the value of gain. It is unity. That is nothing but gain is equal to 1. Okay, na? So the level shifting stage provides unity gain, and it has high input resistance and low output resistance. The level shifting stage is having high input resistance and low output resistance. So that it acts as a buffer. What is buffer? The buffer is used for impedance matching. Okay, na? And always the input is having high input resistance or high input impedance, and output is having low output impedance. So in order to maintain this, the level shifting stage acts as a buffer. Okay, na? So here this buffer is used as the output of the amplifier is used to match with the input of the amplifier. Okay, na? That is used as a buffer, and here it is also, here the level shifting stage is also used to eliminate the signal distortion. Okay, na? The level shifting stage is used for eliminate the signal distortion, and this level shifting stage is used to adjust the DC voltage. It is used to adjust the DC voltage so that the output will vary about a zero reference level. The output will vary about a zero difference level. So therefore it prevents the any undesirable current to the load and increases the output voltage swing. Okay, it is used to increase the output voltage. Okay, na? Amplifier is nothing but it is used to increasing the voltage, kada? Without any change in the signal shape and frequency. Okay, na? So next, coming to the next stage, output stage. So here in the output stage we are using the circuit, it is nothing but complementary push-pull power amplifier. So this output stage, it is very essential for providing decrease in output impedance. It provides decrease in output impedance. Always the circuit is having low output impedance, kada? So this complementary push-pull power amplifier is used to decreases the output impedance. Okay, na? So so that the output power is having, the output will having voltage level is going to be increased. Okay na? So compulsory, if a circuit is having compulsory impedance impedance matching is nothing but always the input is having high input resistance, output is having low output resistance, so then only the output voltage is going to be increased. So here the complementary push pull power amplifier is used. It is essential for providing decrease of output impedance. Okay, now it will decreases the output impedance in order to increase the output swing or output voltage. Okay, now. So coming to this, here this is the diagram for op amp. Here we are having four stages, and these are the two inputs: inverting input, non-inverting input means it is indicated by positive. Inverting input means it is indicated by negative. So for differential amplifier, we are giving two inputs now: voltage one and voltage two. Okay, now the differential amplifier is a circuit. It is used to accept the two input signal, and it is used to amplify the difference between these two input signal. Those are nothing but inverting input and non-inverting input. Okay, now. So finally, the block diagram of operational amplifier consists of four stages. Okay, now first stage is nothing but input stage. Second stage is also another input, another differential amplifier stage, and third stage is level shifting stage, acts as a emitter follower or buffer, and output circuit is nothing but complementary push pull power amplifier. Mainly the complementary push pull power amplifier is used for it is used to decrease the output impedance so that it will increases the swing, output swing. Okay na? So here this is, we are having four stages, and for op amp we have to give the two power supplies: positive power supply and negative power supply. Okay na? So and this is the output. We are going to get the one output. Okay? So always the input is having high input resistance and output is having low output resistance. So this is about the block diagram of operational amplifier. Into the next topic, pin diagram of IC741. So the IC74 is nothing but most commonly used operational amplifier, and it is nothing but it acts as the op amp. This op amp acts as a voltage amplifier. Voltage amplifier is nothing but it is used to increase the voltage level. It is used to increase the strength of the signal. Okay na? So and the output voltage, whatever you are getting the output voltage, it is 180 degrees output signal. It is 180 degrees out of phase with the input signal. Okay na? So here coming to the pin diagram of IC741. Here we have, it is IC741 is 8 pin IC. It is having totally 8 pins. Okay na? And it is available in dual in package. And we can, it is commonly used in any type of electronic circuits. Okay na? Coming to the operational amplifier applications. The applications of op amp is nothing but like it is adder. It can act as adder. That is nothing but it is used to add the two input signals, and it acts as a difference, and it acts as a comparator, differentiator and integrator, and voltage follower. So these are the applications of the operational amplifier. Coming to the pin diagram, totally we are having 8 pins. So the first pin, it is nothing but offset null, and second pin it is inverting input, third pin it is non-inverting input, fourth pin negative power supply, fifth pin offset null, sixth pin output terminal, and positive power supply is nothing but seventh pin, and eighth pin is no connection. Coming to the pin description of IC741, here the first pin and fifth pin are nothing but we are not using these pins. Okay, now we are not using these pins. That is nothing but offset null. And coming to the second pin, it is nothing but inverting input. We are giving the negative going signal. Okay na? We are giving the negative going signal. Inverting means negative. Okay na? So this is giving at the pin of second pin. And third pin is nothing but non-inverting input. So for the op amp, we are having two inputs kada. First one it is inverting input, and another one it is non-inverting input. Okay na? First pin is positive going signal, and second one it is negative going signals. So differential mode signals, we have to give this to the second pin and third pin. Coming to the fourth pin, it is negative power supply. The negative terminal of the power supply is giving to the fourth pin of the operational amplifier. And coming to the sixth pin, this is the nothing but this is the output pin. Coming to the seventh pin, the positive terminal of the power supply is connected with the seventh pin, and eighth pin is nothing but node connection. We are not giving any connections to the eighth pin. So this is the pin description of the IC741. So this is 8 pin dual in line package signal. And coming to the symbol, so this is the symbol of the IC741. So here we are taking the output, and these are the input signals. So the input signals are second pin and third pin. Okay, now second pin is inverting input, third pin is non-inverting input, and seventh pin is positive power supply, and fourth pin is negative power supply. Okay, now so this is the symbol. It is very very important. And coming to the two definitions, differential mode gain. What is the meaning of differential mode gain? So it is used to give the gain of the two common signals. Okay, now that is nothing but common mode gain. Differential mode gain is nothing but it is used to give the two differential inputs. One is positive going signal, another is negative going signal. So these are the definitions of differential mode gain, common mode gain. Okay, now so the gain whatever we are giving, it is different between the two input signals. Common mode gains, here we are taking the two inputs as common. Okay, now so this is about pin diagram, and see, this is the symbol of IC741. So coming to the next topic, characteristics of ideal operational amplifier. Infinite voltage gain. It is having infinite voltage gain. What is voltage gain? Output voltage to the input voltage. It is about infinity. And infinite input impedance and zero output impedance, zero offset voltage, infinite bandwidth. What is bandwidth? The difference between upper cutoff frequency to the lower cutoff frequency. Infinite common mode rejection ratio, infinite slew rate. Characteristics, do not drift with temperature. Next, coming to the characteristics of practical op amp. Voltage is very high, it is in terms of mega ohms. Input impedance is also high, up to it is 2 mega ohms. Output impedance is, it is very low, it is about 100 ohms. Input offset voltage is very low, that is about 100 microvolts. CMRR is up to 90 decibels. Slew rate is up to 0.01 volts per microseconds. Bandwidth is up to 1 megahertz. Okay.